You know, this question about what should be our ideal political cycle is something where I fluctuate. From time to time, I take the view when you've got a bad government, get them out, and we'll have a short-term cycle. But the trouble with a long-term cycle is that if it is defined that it must be 5 years and you get a bad government, then how do you get rid of them? So I think we maybe need a trade-off between a longer cycle and a recall. I know that's controversial, but that balance might do it.
Short-term political cycles are a problem. Whether it's 3 years or 5 years can be a problem. I think with the world moving as fast as it is, with technology, with interconnectedness and with education, short-termism results in a lack of trust in a whole lot of institutions. And I think somehow we need to rebuild trust. There's a great book called The Decay of Power by Moses Naim, and it just highlights that really well.
I think our electoral cycle, the three-year federal electoral cycle in particular, is part of the dynamic. I'm not sure that is the only reason why we might be struggling to compete globally. I think we do compete fairly well in some markets and we win some markets. I don't necessarily point though to the electoral cycle, the three-year cycle especially, as being a roadblock for us. I think it's a challenge. It's a challenge that needs to be managed. But whether you're talking a three-year electoral cycle, a four-year cycle, in the end it might not make that much difference. What matters the most is making sure that the government of the day and successive governments that come after that have a consistency of approach to long-term policy making.
I don't believe the cycle of political elections, whether it's 3 years, 4 years or 5 years, is actually at the heart of where the challenge is. I think we do have too much focus on short-termism, and I would like to see government rise above the political cycle and set out agendas in a cross-bench focus for our medium and long-term.